Hi, I have an amazing job shared by only four people in the entire world. I design bowling balls. There's one real reason why I'm so happy and excited to have the job that I have. You see, it's because I found my passion. So today what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk to you a little bit about my passion, a little bit about my story, and give you some tips to be able to find your passion as well. You see, it all started with my father, who's a big-time bowler. I would travel around the country with him, and at one tournament event that he was at, I was actually able to meet a bowling ball designer. And I inquired with that bowling ball designer, how hard can it be to design a bowling ball? It's round. He said, well, it really depends on what you really want to do, because there's two parts to a bowling ball. You see, there's actually the outside of the bowling ball. It's called the cover stock. If you want to design the cover stock, you actually need a degree in chemical engineering. I was like, whoa. If you want to design the inside piece, that's called the core. That requires a degree in mechanical engineering. You're also going to have to do some things to be able to get into the industry, because the industry is very small. You're going to need some pro shop experience. That's the place that you go to where they actually put the holes in the bowling ball. Additionally, you're going to need to take some time and keep in contact with as many people as you can within the industry, because it's just such a small niche field, right? So I left the tournament, went home, and thought, you know what? I think that's what I want to do. I want to design bowling balls. So I said, well, I guess I better get me a job in this pro shop and figure out how to start drilling bowling balls. And I did that. And then I said, okay, well, I guess I better start making some phone calls to people in the industry. And I did that. And then came the big decision. What school am I going to go to? Well, you know, I needed two things for the school. I needed a top-ranked, high-powered engineering program. I also needed a good bowling team. So, of course, I chose Purdue University. Boiler up! While I was at Purdue, I had to make another decision. Was I going to go the chemical engineering route or the mechanical engineering route? After one, and I repeat, one long, hard, excruciatingly stressful chemistry class, I said, I'm designing the core. So I also needed some experience. So for two of my spring breaks, I worked for free for bowling ball manufacturers. Ultimately, I was able to bowl for the Purdue bowling team as captain. And when it came time to graduate, because of the experience that I had, I was able to get a job working for the world's largest bowling ball supplier, Ebonite International. Within 6 months of being hired, I was designing all of the core shapes for Ebonite, the brand. Today, I design core shapes for four different brands that make up roughly 60% of the world's supply of bowling balls. So now that you guys have a little bit about my story, let's talk about the core shape. So this is the core of a bowling ball. You see, the core is the steering mechanism in the bowling ball. It's kind of what makes it hook and makes it curve. You've seen that before on TV, right? Well, likewise, the core is also inside of a person. See, it's called their passion. And in bowling, there are two types of cores. There's the round core shape, and there's what's called the asymmetrical core shape. See, the round core shape is a very common shape. In fact, when you go bowling at the bowling center, that's the core that's in your bowling ball. Now, this bowling ball goes straight, it doesn't offer much performance, and ultimately, a lot of times, it ends up in the gutter. But see, now you understand why. See, because the core that you have inside of your bowling ball, it's not meant to do anything. Well, people that are not passionate or haven't found their passion are a lot like the round core bowling ball. Because see, in a similar fashion, unfortunately, they haven't figured out the way to be able to take maybe what they have thought as their passion, but turn it into a career. Or maybe they don't even know what their passion is. And a lot of times, they too could end up in the gutter, because they don't fully realize the potential that they actually have if they were able to find their passion. But that's okay, because there is a place for the round core in bowling. You see, the round core in bowling is used to shoot spares. Spares are the pins that are left after you've made a first ball attempt, but were unable to knock down all of the pins. Now, that's not really what you want to be like. You want to be like the asymmetrical core shape. See, the asymmetrical core shape is high-powered. It's big hooking, it's great performing, it looks kind of different. In fact, this one's made with some unique materials like carbon fiber for durability and strength. See, the asymmetrical core shape is very symbolic of people that have found their passion, because they're not afraid to do things that other people are scared to do, like talk in front of a bunch of strangers for 10 minutes. They're also very driven to do things that are different, like, you know, saying, hey, well, you know what? I think I want to design bowling balls when I grow up. The asymmetric core shape is also replicated of the person who's found their passion, because you see, when the asymmetric core shape goes down the lane, it actually comes back to the pocket. So you throw it away from the pins, but then it comes right back to the pocket, to the pins, right? People that have found their passion, once you figure out what it is, man, it pulls you into it. It draws you into it. It becomes part of you. So that's well and good. And you know, there are some benefits to being able to find and follow your passion. For me, one of the greatest benefits that I've been able to find so far is that I don't ever work a day in my life. And you say, well, how is that possible, right? Well, here's the deal. When you find your passion and you can follow it, what ends up happening is you don't go to work, you go to play. So when I get up in the morning and I head to the office, it's going to be another fun day in paradise. You know, the CEO of Ebonite once said to me, he said, Ron, when your work becomes work, it's time to find new work. And really what that means is if you're not doing something that you love, then stop doing it. Find something that you love and start doing that. When you do that, you'll become very successful in what you do. One of the best things that I enjoy from my job on a daily basis is being able to help other people. And as a result of being able to design bowling balls and interact with people, you find that you get additional gratification from things that you get to experience. As an example, just 2 weeks ago, I was bowling in the Tennessee State Singles Championships alongside my father. I was able to watch him bowl his highest three-game set ever, 820. He struck an amazing 86% of the time. I was in complete awe, because that was like the best he's ever bowled in his entire life, and I'm sitting there, and I'm struggling to get a strike. You know, it was gratifying, obviously, to watch him bowl and be able to see all the things, all the excitement, and all the people high-fiving and cheering. But at the end of the day on the ride back, I thought, man, that was really cool to watch. But you know what? I played a small role in his success. Because you see the bowling ball that he used, I designed. So now, it's very gratifying to be able to hear stories of people that have their first 300 game or their first 800 series or their high game of their career, especially when you're having a bad day. You know, that's one of the beautiful things about doing this job, because you're able to help people that you never even meet. You know, I really feel like standing up here talking to you today, it's like my 30-self-something being able to speak to my 20-self-something and offer him some pointers to have a happy, successful life. But you see, the real key is, not only are you able to have a happy, successful life, but you also get to help make the world a better place. So I hope that by giving you some tips today and talking to you a little bit, that I can help you begin to design your own asymmetrical core to keep you and your bowling ball out of the gutter, and to become a striking success. Thank you.